So tell me, yesterday, what happened yesterday? Did you get a call from your mom, or just walk me through what happened during the day yesterday?
I remember that I had blood tested done like a couple weeks back. My mom said they came back positive for Marfan syndrome.
And what did you think when your mom said that? What did you know about that to know how to react to that?
Knew that they said I wouldn't be able to play basketball anymore at a competitive level. They found the gene in my blood sample and they told me that my arteries in my heart are enlarged and that if I overwork myself or push too hard that my heart could rupture. The draft is 4 days away, and you know, I had a dream that my name was gonna be called. But, I'm sorry, I can't even think of it.
I know this is a very difficult situation. Is there anything else you want to share about this process or what you've learned?
Well, for all my supporters, you know, I just want to tell them sorry. I'm sorry they couldn't see me play in the NBA. But it's not the end, you know.
Before we continue tonight, I want to take a moment to recognize Baylor center Isaiah Austin. You may have heard about Isaiah. He is one of the nation's best collegiate players and was expected to be picked tonight before the discovery just a few days ago that he had a genetic disorder called Marfan syndrome and is no longer able to play competitive basketball. Like the other young men here tonight, Isaiah committed himself through endless hard work and dedication to a potential career as a professional basketball player, and we wanted to make sure he fulfilled at least this part of his dream. So it gives me great pleasure to say that with the next pick in the 2014 NBA draft, the NBA selects Isaiah Austin from Baylor University.
Isaiah, what is it like for you to be here in the green room, get called up to the podium with Adam Silver, and watch a night that you've been looking forward to hearing your name for so long?
It's one of the biggest blessings of my life. I've worked so hard to get to this point, and unfortunately it was taken away, but when God closes one door, he opens up another for you.
How has the process been over the last couple of days throughout the fact that you won't be able to play competitive basketball again?
It's been the toughest week of my life, you know, but I have a great support system behind me. My family has been with me the whole way, and God has really just put willpower in my heart to help me push through this.
You said earlier in a quote that it's not the end, it's the beginning. And can you describe what that means? What's the next step for Isaiah Austin?
I'm going to dream again. I'm going to go around. I'm going to share my story with as many people as I can. And I'm just hoping to touch people's lives and let them know that any obstacle that they're facing, they can get through it. All they have to do is keep a positive mind and thank God for every moment that they're on this earth.
Congratulations, Isaiah.
Thank you. I appreciate it.